This is John Colin with growingyourdreams.com. Today we're at Rick and Karen's house with the garden update. So you saw the series of videos. There are 7 videos in all showing basically taking their backyard to Rick and Karen going out to shopping for the stuff and the materials to make the beds. And then we're over here, you know, making the beds, and the whole series is on. But many viewers asked, well, how is the garden doing now? So I'm back today after, I don't know, at least a month or so. They've been eating lettuce from their raised bed garden several times. They got the tomatoes doing really well. They have basil, marigolds that actually the slugs are eating instead of the things they're growing in the garden. They got cucumbers and some broccoli and cauliflower, and the tree collards are doing really well. And they even got so motivated, they got a little another container growing here with more lettuce. And let's check out over on this side of the yard. This is how truly easy it is to start growing your own food. Once they got really into growing and planted that bed out, they had a friend come over with more starts, and they said, well, where are we gonna put them? So they literally just took some of the compost that they had out in the front and lined it up and made a raised bed. Now this raised bed is a very simple raised bed. It doesn't have any sides or anything. It doesn't have any irrigation, but it's simply easy as that. You just take some compost, put it in, and plant your plants inside there. They're out here hand watering this section, but you know what? Everything's gonna grow, and it really is that easy. So you don't have to take, you know, a lot of time to build nice raised beds. You can just dump some compost and start growing. And that's the main thing. If you start growing, you're gonna get the gardening bug. It's gonna be fun, especially after the first time you harvest some of your greens and things you harvest and eat. It's really so delicious. We're on the right side of the raised bed here in Rick and Karen's backyard. I'm here with Karen, who's been tending most of the gardening. And let's see, they have a couple things planted, including my ones I like the most, the tree collards. But Karen is gonna tell us about some of the other things that are planted on this side of the bed.
Right, so in addition to the tree collards, we also have some broccoli and some cauliflower. And then starting over here, we actually have some cucumbers. Now what's interesting about this bed is that we actually planted some companion herbs or companion plants that actually grow very well with cabbage family plants. And here we have some dill, and as you can see, it's gotten pretty tall just in the past couple of weeks. And then we have some chamomile over here as well, and supposedly that creates a favorable environment for the cabbage family plants to grow.
All right, Karen, great. So I see you also have some marigolds.
Oh yeah, marigolds. So let's move over to this bed here and I can show you a little bit more about the marigolds. Now marigolds in general are good plants for keeping certain types of insects out of the garden. What I have found to be interesting about the marigolds this year though is that for some reason the snails and the slugs that come out at night and come into the garden seem to be very attracted to the marigolds, and it looks as though they have eaten a lot of the marigolds that I've put in. But what's even more interesting is that they have avoided the other plants, and they have really just concentrated on the marigolds, which is something that I've never seen before. I thought that was very interesting. And here we have a few different types of lettuce. We have some oak leaf, and then we have some green leaf over here. Then we've got a couple of different types of romaine over here on this side. And then in the middle, we have some red leaf and a few different types of romaine. And I think we have just a regular Boston head lettuce here.
Well, that's a manioa lettuce.
Karen. Oh, it is a manioa lettuce. Okay, thank you for correcting me, John. But what's interesting about this is that some of the lettuce obviously is growing more than the others.
And so these were planted at the same time, right?
They were all planted at the same time. I don't know exactly why some of them have been growing more than others, but Rick and I thought we did a little experiment by planting a wide variety and see which ones grow the best at this time of year. We have one particular variety here that is primarily a winter lettuce, and as you can see, it's probably the smallest of all of them. And then the Hawaiian lettuce that John mentioned before is doing reasonably well, but maybe that grows better in Hawaii than here. Maybe it likes more of a humid or more hot environment than we can provide.
Yeah, the lettuces are really interesting because they planted all these at the same time, and all these lettuces are from different places. So this is from the guy I like to go to, Glenn, at the farmer's market. These ones are from Harmony Farm Nursery, and these last ones are actually from Sweetwater Nursery. All three local nurseries that raise the plants, but you know, maybe, you know, some were, you know, different varieties may have a factor in how they grow because the watering and the soil is the same amongst all of them. Maybe some were, you know, transplanted too late. Maybe they got stunted growth because they were in a little pot too long and they got too much root, encroachment inside there. And I find that sometimes if you wait too long before planting, the thing will just never really grow that well. But who knows, you know, it's good. Experimentation is actually really important when gardening and in life. So, you know, try different things and see what works. Maybe next year they're going to plant more of these because they're going to grow faster and they may still play around with these and or not. But it's definitely important when you're gardening to have an open mind and try new things and see what works and find out what doesn't work and keep doing what works and maybe don't do the things that don't work.
And finally, we have a variety of different types of tomatoes. We have a couple of hybrids kind of sprinkled throughout this bed, and then we also have some, are they called light bulb tomatoes right over there?
I see some, green zebras over here?
Yeah, we have some heirlooms, green zebras right here, and then we have some pineapple heirlooms, which are down in through here. I don't know if they have started fruiting yet, but we're hoping so because we really love those. And then we have some cherry tomatoes towards the end there, and I believe that a couple of them have started to fruit as well. So we'll see how those do as we go along.
So I did want to just point out too, they're using rebar, and rebar is a really good way to stake your plants up. It's really sturdy and strong. They're also using some bamboo stakes as well, and especially because they're growing in a raised bed, it's really important to grow vertical. So they're training their plants to grow vertically by doing the staking, which is very important. Rick and Karen are even growing in containers, and these are basically wine barrels or half wine barrels or whiskey barrels, half of it cut in half, makes a great planting area and planting space. So it looks like in here they have some tomatoes with some marigolds, and these were planted in mid-May, and you could see these are much further along than the tomatoes in the raised beds that are recently planted. So even if you don't have space for a raised bed, you could grow in a wine barrel. So Karen, are there any good plants that grow well with tomatoes, like if you want to grow plants next to them?
Yeah, actually we have a couple in here that I can show you. This one right here is basil, and supposedly that really helps tomatoes grow very well, and supposedly marigolds do as well. And I've actually already started harvesting this basil, and it is really, really good, and we're just waiting on the tomatoes at this point.
All right, great. Have you started harvesting your marigolds yet?
No, haven't done that. What are those good for?
They're good to eat. The flowers are really rich in lutein and zeaxanthin.
Oh, wow, great.
Really powerful antioxidants.
The
flavor takes a little bit of getting used to, but I just made a soup the other day with the marigolds petals blended into the soup, and you know, you get all that extraction of the antioxidants in there, and has a nice unique flavor and change the color, made it a nice pretty color.
Oh, wow.
You could also just take them and take the whole head and sprinkle them on your salad, you know, at night.
Hey, we'll have to try that. It makes sense that there's lutein and zeaxanthin in the marigolds because lutein and zeaxanthin are yellow pigments. So you're going to find lutein and zeaxanthin in yellow, sometimes orange, and maybe even red fruits and vegetables, and obviously in some flowers as well.
So these are the impromptu beds that Rick and Karen put together. So Karen, why don't you tell us about, you know, why you created these beds and how you did it and what you planted?
Well, first of all, Rick and I took some of the compost that we got from Sonoma Compost and we laid it down here in this bed that we have here, and we planted a few different types of plants. We planted some zucchini, some yellow crookneck squash, and some gold bar squash. And as you can see, a lot of them are doing extremely well. Some of them have already flowered, and some of them are actually already producing fruit. So we'll see later in the year when John does another update how these are all doing.
All right, yeah, it looks so good. So they just, yeah, they had extra plants, laid down some compost, and just planted in it, and that's how easy it is. There's no definition on the sides, and there's no irrigation, but how often do you have to come out here and water, Karen?
I usually come out maybe once every day or once every other day, and I usually do it after the sun has gone down, just so that there isn't water left on the leaves that could potentially cause problems for the leaves, so I usually like to water at night.
Great, great. Yeah, well, your garden all looks really great, and the last thing I'd like to ask you, Kieran, is what did you learn from doing this whole process of, you know, building the raised beds and, you know, putting in irrigation and planting the plants? I mean, I know you've had a garden experience before and have had gardens in the past, but what would you like to share with my viewers that you think could really help them, you know, in their quest to grow some of their own food?
It can be as simple or as complex as you would like to make it. You could go so far as we did with that bed over there by actually building the raised beds and putting in irrigation, or you could just lay out some compost here and plant it. It's just as simple as that, and hand water. So I would say if you're curious about gardening, the best thing to do is just to get started and do some experimenting and see where it goes from there.
Excellent advice. I definitely would totally agree. All right, so thank you, Kieran. So this is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time.